Hi everyone, I'm Fran Charles and welcome to another edition of The Nine presented by the USGA, and pleased to be joined by John Mummert, who heads all things photography here at the USGA. And John, we're going to flip the script a little bit and we're going to spend some time on the art of still photography and take a look back at the nine most memorable moments from 2016. And John, you guys have assembled an unbelievable team. They've been involved with golf for decades and they've gone out and taken a gazillion number of shots, but what's the goal when it comes to what you're looking for in terms of great photography?
Yeah, when we go out, whether it's, you know, at a championship or, you know, covering an LPGA, USGA girls golf, or even recreational golfers, the goal is to be storytellers. The guys that we're sending out are photojournalists, and what we want them to do is give viewers a glimpse into the sport that maybe they haven't seen before. You know, whether it's bringing them behind the scenes access, whether it's using the creativity of the photographers or even the editors to find that unique angle and show them something that they haven't seen.
No better image to start with than this first one, which is one I think we all can relate to, which is awesome. It looks like a father and a son here, and a father teaching his son how to start to play golf.
No, this simple photo says so many different things. This is part of a photo essay that Darren Carroll did for us on a golf course in New Orleans, and it is a father and son. It's U.S. Representative Cedric Richmond teaching his son, you know, just how to get started in the game. And, you know, for many of us, you know, that's how I started. It was my father taking me out in the afternoon and showing me how to grip the club and the simple things.
Keep your eye on the ball. He's got that head down.
That's what it is.
He's off to a great start. So. This is amazing. I mean, another beautiful shot at Oakmont. And it's up pretty high, and I know you're a tall guy, but I know you can't get up that high. How did you position yourself or your camera to be in this spot to grab the shot?
So one of the things we do long before a championship like the US Open will get on site is we go and we scout the golf course. We look at different vantage points. One of our goals is to take our viewers to somewhere that they haven't been, somewhere that they haven't seen before. And that's exactly what this frame was. We went out early Sunday morning, long before the grounds crews even got to the church pews, and we set a remote camera up high up on one of the platforms. That image was then transmitted back to us in the media center, where it went up on usopen.com minutes after it occurred.
John, what I love about this photo here with Jack and Dustin is the intimacy between those two, even though there's obviously a ton of people around.
Yeah, this is one of those quiet moments that still photography captures so well. You know, there were millions of people around the world watching. It was just a small moment between two champions that almost no one saw, but Joel Kowski, one of our photographers, was there and captured that small little wink that Jack's given Dustin.
And some of that is just luck, I mean, right? I mean, you can put yourself in the best position, but
absolutely. And that's so much of what it is doing your homework, putting yourself in that right position, then letting magic happen.
Great stuff. John, this is pretty neat. You can see a locked-in Dustin Johnson getting an opportunity to see his name engraved here on the U.S. Open trophy.
Yeah, this is golf photojournalism, I think, at its best. One of the things that we do is we assign one of our photographers, in this case it was Darren Carroll, to spend the evening with the champion. So from the moment that last putt drops, the photographer will go with the champion and, you know, capture those little moments. Rather than me telling you the story, why don't we let our photographer, Darren Carroll, do that?
All right, Darren, jump in.
Thanks, Fran and John. One of my favorite things about Sunday at the U.S. Open is getting the chance to spend some time with the champion after the last putt drops, from signing his scorecard to media availability to just spending time with his family. One of the things that the USGA started doing 2 years ago was having the engraver present in the clubhouse to put the champion's name on the trophy right in front of him. And it makes for some interesting pictures because, as you see with Dustin Johnson from last year, this is the moment when it starts to hit home that this actually happened. And I think the look on Dustin's face says it all.
John, tell us about the team's collective resume.
It's pretty impressive. When you put everybody together, we have over 195 years of golf coverage. We've covered 160 U.S. Opens, over 450 majors, 16 Olympics, 18 Super Bowls, 38 Final Fours, 19 World Series, 46 Kentucky Derbies, 15 Indy 500s, 22 Daytona 500s. And one of the stats that people ask a lot is, well, what about Sports Illustrated? Our team's had nearly 60 covers.
John, we know all about the championships that the USGA puts on, but this photo is really what it's all about.
Yeah, this is from an LPGA USGA girls golf clinic in North Carolina. Jason Mizek, you know, really just caught the joy that, you know, all of us as golfers feel, but it's pretty neat when you put golf clubs in people's hands and, you know, just seeing the smiles and the joy popping out.
I love it. They're all fired up.
Makes you want to go play.
There you go. John, what a year In Jung Song had. I mean, she won the U.S. Girls Junior and also the U.S. Women's Amateur. And this is awesome. I mean, with all the water up and the celebration here in the picture.
This is a great moment that Steve Gibbons caught right after she won. And here she is celebrating with her friends and fellow competitors, which is really shows the friendship, the sportsmanship, and camaraderie that this game brings out.
First to win the girls junior and also the U.S. Women Amateur in the same year.
Pretty amazing.
John, this photo is simply breathtaking. I mean, with all the different colors, when's the best time here, dusk or dawn, for a photographer to snap a shot like this?
Boy, that's a trick question. We actually call it magic hour, and it's both. It's that, you know, time just before the sun comes up, as it's coming up, right after, and then again at the end of the day when it sets. This particular one was bright and early in the morning, and as you can see, before that sun came up, Chris Keene got out there, and we call it dawn patrol. You know, he was out there and he caught this special moment. And it's, you know, everything from the sky to the light reflecting off the windows and the flags. And, you know, that one lone golfer on the first round of stroke play at the USAM.
Hey, get you set. Let you know the day's about to begin.
The quiet before the storm.
John, another early morning shot here. And the grounds crew out getting the course ready.
Yeah, this was Chris Keene working again early in the morning. This is Darren Brevard, our lead championship agronomist, using a snip meter, checking green speeds out on the golf course. And there, you know, so many things working for this photo. You know, A, it's somebody out there, you know, doing what they do when nobody's looking. And the photographer, for that matter, you know, being out there when no one's looking. But, you know, the angle that Chris chose, putting the grass low in the foreground, gives you those, you know, beautiful halos. And, you know, obviously the light on the golf course at that hour is just gorgeous.
And I love it too, the thoroughness. Obviously, that's the third ball that he's rolling off, which shows you the thoroughness here of the preparation.
Absolutely.
John, I look at this photo and I just say, wow, because there's so much going on and a couple things that stand out to me, but I'll let you take the first crack at it.
No, there really is. As a photo editor, the first thing you look at is that girl's smile. It's contagious. It just makes you want to smile. You know, the little guy, you know, working with her and helping her tee up the ball. If you took the rainbow out of it, those two things alone would make it a great photo. Now you add a rainbow into it, and it's just, it's got everything that you could ever want.
Yeah, I think the smile is unbelievable, and it's almost like in the shadows, but it still is powerful enough where, I mean, it makes the whole picture warm, and then obviously the rainbow. But where was this taken, and what's going on here?
Yeah, Steve Gibbons captured this moment in Oregon. And it's a program there that is working to make the game more accessible and more inclusive to all golfers.
Amen to that.
Pretty special.
So John, from 200,000 shots whittled down to just 9, I mean, we really can't emphasize enough the great work that these photographers do.
No, it's an honor to sit here and represent the photographers and the editing team. They are diligent in what they do. They're incredibly hardworking and passionate. Most people wouldn't know it, but our crew is on the golf course from often 5 a.m., if not earlier, through the end of the day, through the last putt, plus 2 hours editing.
So if you like these 9 shots, by the way, make sure you check out usga.org for the 25 shots of the year. And then also, by the way, follow the USGA on Instagram for pictures and videos throughout the year. They keep rolling along, so you get great images like this all season long. So for John, I'm Fran. Thanks for watching another edition of The 9. We'll catch you next time.